Sarah Champion, we are backstage at the fantastic 80s Rewind Festival, and I'm delighted to be joined by the Straits, fresh from the stage. How was that for you?
Cool. Hot and sweaty, not really cool, it is wonderful, really.
Very cool and hot and sweaty.
Cool and sweaty. Yeah.
The exact opposite of cool, in fact.
Smiley faces, that's a great crowd.
Yes.
Stunning crowd, smiley faces, strange wigs, all the stuff, you know. Yeah. Great festival.
I think that's what makes this festival. You know, we do a few over the summer in our camper van, and this one, for me, just the atmosphere out there is electric.
Just incredibly happy people. It sounds, sounds such a cliche at festivals, but really, there's just a wonderful buzz in the air here.
Yes.
Helped by the weather for once. Couple of weeks ago, we played in pouring rain and looked like Vietnam, you know?
Yeah, that's not so great. No. I guess as a band, does that give you incentive to go out and kind of lift the crowd who are standing there in the pouring rain?
In a way, you just always want to do your best. So if it's raining, you know you're going to have to get out there and do a bit. So, mind you, I have to say, working with these guys, every time I get out there, within seconds, they've lifted me to wherever it's going to be anyway. So it's just great.
I have to say, I think the crowd visibly lifted on the opening chords of Walk of Life. Yeah. It just happened.
Nice.
So how long have you been playing with the band now? Is it just over a year?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, just about that. And it feels longer in a good way, though. It feels really natural.
For me, it feels like about 30 years.
It's been great, but it's more than just playing. You know, we're writing together, and you know, there's recording together, and there's just a lot to it behind the scenes, not just these few minutes on stage that people see. You know, and touring, it's lovely, it really
and
is.
And Terrence, I mean, the story is that Alan, your wife, found Terrence via YouTube. Is that correct? Has that been embellished?
We were kind of having a look around on the internet. I thought I'll see if there's anybody out there. And I'd kind of given up and gone to make a cup of tea. She kept looking, and then I heard this voice and guitar coming out of the computer. And I went running back in. I went, hang on, who's that?
Huh?
And to cut my long story short, it was him.
It's him.
Yeah.
Easy.
So, how did that feel to get that phone call?
Oh, yeah, I've said it before. I just thought it was a wind-up.
Really?
I just thought it was ridiculous. And he literally said, hello, my name's Alan Clark. I'm the keyboard player from Dire Straits. We're getting back together, you know, Mark doesn't want to do it. Fancy having a crack. The story's mad. And it really was that. He was as blunt about it as that. And, it just got to that point where I thought to not do it would be more stupid than doing it. It's a fine line at one point. And I thought, no, let's give it a go. Let's see what it's all about. But strangely enough, once we got into a room together, as people, and it just felt very natural. I don't know how else to explain it, really. It just felt very natural.
Mm.
Natural to get together and start to play.
It just works. It worked then, it works now, so
Yeah. When someone came over, just before you came into the camper van, someone said, and of course Terrence is much better looking than Mark Knopfler. And I went, oh, well, I guess that's not going to harm you, is it?
Yeah.
So you guys are touring right now, I take it?
Yes.
Yeah, in fact, we're on a plane in a couple of days off to Romania, and then a show in Switzerland after France, then a little bit of a break, and then we're back at it again in a few weeks' time. Yeah.
And how have you found the reaction from Dire Straits fans? On the whole, has it been a positive one to the new lineup?
Very, very positive, actually. Really encouraging, and to be honest, kind of humbling, too, because we've known them one way or another for a long, long time. And they're still there, and they, you know, people accept Terrence, and they feel that this music is part of their lives somehow.
Yeah.
And the ones that we know from old, but there's also a young crew who come along as well, who have found it through the internet, who are discovering it for the first time now, which is fantastic, you know. So it's really great. The response from the fans has been great.
I think you encompass it exactly with it's the music of people's lives. As you were playing, Lisa, who works with us, said, oh, Romeo and Juliet, this is mine and my boyfriend's song. This is mine and my boyfriend's song.
I know.
So that's what
happens. It is exactly what happens, I think.
I think, you know, to use a word that is now from a very different era, you know, songs that have been around for that long kind of go viral.
Yes.
They become part of the atmosphere, and, you know, Dire Straits sold countless tens of millions of records, and it just becomes part of your furniture and becomes part of your life as people's relationships, babies, and
of course.
So they kind of own the music in a way. So
yeah. And embellishing on that, Alan, I mean, this is an 80s festival. What do you think it is about 80s music that makes it kind of such a halcyon decade for music? I mean, Absolute 80s is one of our most successful radio stations. We have an 80s show on a Friday night that everybody loves. So what is it about that decade in particular, do you think?
I don't know, really. I mean, it was just, yeah, there's just a lot of great music out there in the 80s, and there are lots of young people growing up listening to 80s music, the music their parents were listening to, and they've kind of latched onto it. I don't know, maybe, I don't know what the answer is to that, really. It was just a good decade.
Yeah.
Also, the drug scene eased off during the 80s, so more of us are alive.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. There is that as
so
well.
So, we can come out and do it. Thank you very much.
Well, we missed the 60s.
Yeah. Are you going to be sticking around now to enjoy some of the Rewind Festival?
Yeah, absolutely.
There's some mates out there. I'm going to wander out in a minute. And,
I thought, it must be a bit like a school reunion, is it?
Kind of. No, it's cool.
Who do you count in amongst your mates that are here today, then?
Nobody. That people would know, just okay. Friends from kind of where I live now.
Yeah, you see a couple of people waving across, you know, and and backstage is quite interesting. It's just like rows of guitars and drum kits and amplifiers, you know, everyone looking at everyone else's gear, you know. Oh, what are you playing?
Yeah.
Well, guys, we're gonna let you enjoy it. Get yourself a well-earned beer, maybe some water to dehydrate in this weather.
Thank you very much.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Cheers.